Good morning, dear students. I am Dr. Chaudhary, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, working in RMD Engineering College. In this session, I am going to explain the concept continuity. The word continuity itself having the direct meaning, continuous, having no break. Now, how it is applied in mathematics? Let us discuss the concept now. Before that, you all know one app. Please read this one, Google Map. Not only me, you 99% of you are using Google Map, because nowadays people, wherever they want to go, immediately they type the destination in Google Map. From the point, they are searching several possibilities how to reach the places. For example, if you choose the starting point or starting station, Avadi, the person from Avadi, he want to reach the station Chennai Central. So what he is doing, you know, he typed the word Chennai Central in Google Map. Now Google Map shows some result. What are the results? First, bike, car, bus, train, and etc. Okay, now bike results and car results. The results of bike and car gives only one result, from the Avadi to Chennai Central directly, having no break. So mathematically it is called continuous. Now we come to the route from the buses. Sometimes route buses are available. For example, 71E and 120. These two buses are route buses directly from Avadi to Chennai Central without having any break. But sometimes Google Map not only shows the route buses alone, it shows all the results. Its aim, however they are there, the people reach the place from the Avadi to Chennai Central. For example, it shows the result 27H also. This bus not goes to directly Chennai Central. So through this bus, we may stop at Tirumangalam or something, etc. Tirumangalam or Padi. From the Padi, you may go by walk and reach some other place. From the places, we may reach the Chennai Central. So here we have the break Padi or Tirumangalam. Okay, so the person from Avadi to Chennai Central, he couldn't reach directly Chennai Central. He went somewhere. From there, he walked, he passes, then he reached the Chennai Central. So mathematically it is called discontinuous. In this same way, I draw some diagrams. See, this is one curve. See the curve, from the point A to B, there is no break. It is called continuous one. Now see this one. However, the deviation is there, there is no break between this, from the point to this point. This is also continuous. But see this one. See this one. From this, suppose the point is A. Here one curve is there, here one curve is there. But in between this, there is no point of contact between these two. So this is called discontinuity. This is called discontinuity. Now let us see the definition mathematically. If the function f of x is continuous at the point x equal to a, it satisfies the following conditions. For the first point, f of x is defined at x equal to a. That means f of a exists. Second point, the point a, f of x defined at the point a, the left hand side limit, right hand side limit, both are exist. That means limit x tends to a minus f of x equal to limit x tends to a plus, both limits are exist. Finally, limit x tends to a f of x equal to f of a. So, if the function f of x is continuous at the point x equal to a, it must satisfy the following conditions. First one, f of a exists. Second, left hand limit of the function f of x and right hand limit of the function f of x. Then, limit of f of x while x tends to a, it is equal to f of a. If the condition, any one of these condition fails, f of x is not continuous at the point x equal to a. It may be called one-sided continuity. What is the one-sided continuity? For example, now this is the point A. Okay, here the curve is exists. Here also the curve exists except this point. But at the point x equal to a only the function is not exist. But here, but limit x tends to a minus x tends to a minus exists. Okay, then limit x tends to a plus exist. So left limit exists, right limit exists. That means f of x is continuous left side, f of x is continuous right hand side. Now let us see an example to understand the concept. If f of x equal to e power x, if x less than 0, x square if x greater than or equal to 0. Check the f of x is continuous or not. Okay, f of x is continuous or not. Now, see this function. For the better understanding, you may denote the point in a graph. So, here x equal to 0. So, what is the functions are given? X less than 0. X less than 0. The function is e power x. So, f of x equal to e power x when x less than 0. Okay. Open interval. Now, start from a closed interval. X equal to 0 and greater than x. This side. X greater than or equal to 0. What is the function? F of x equal to x square. F of x equal to x square. Now, we are going to check that f of x is continuous or not. In which way we are going to prove that f of x is continuous? Now we studied f of x must exist. Check that whether it exists or not. See, while x values are less than 0, f of x equal to e power x. While x greater than or equal to 0, f of x equal to x square. Now, choosing any points in between this range, substituting this equation. For example, x less than 0. X less than 0. Take one example, x equal to minus 3. So, f of minus 3 equal to e power minus 3. F of x minus 3 equal to e power minus 3 exist. From this point, x equal to 3. So, what is the value? F of 3 equal to 3 square. That is 9. So, that also exists. So, first point, f of x defined at the every points in the interval. Okay, now we are going to check that whether it is continuous at x equal to 0 or not. Whether it is continuous at x equal to 0 or not. We check this condition. What is the second condition? If the function f of x is continuous at x equal to 0, it must satisfy the following condition. Limit x tends to 0 minus f of x equal to limit x tends to 0 plus f of x. Both are equal. Now, x tends to 0 minus, what is f of x? Left hand side, limit x tends to 0 minus f of x equal to e power x. And here limit x tends to 0 plus f of x value equal to x square. Now we substitute the limit values. X tends to 0, x tends to 0 plus. Here minus and plus indicates left side limit, right side limit, or negative values and positive values. Now e power 0 equal to 0 square, e power 0 value equal to 1, 0 square value equal to 0. Are both are equal? No, 1 not equal to 0. So what's the conclusion? These are not equal. So as per the condition, if f of x does not satisfy any one of the condition, f of x is not continuous at the point x equal to 0. Here we conclude this answer, f of x is not continuous at the point 0. Not continuous at the point 0. But we saw that f of x exists x less than 0, f of x exists x greater than or equal to 0. So it may be true, left continuous and the right continuous. Left continuous from minus infinity to 0 and 0 to plus infinity. 0 to plus infinity.